Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and Assalamu alaikum. In the previous video, we have seen the demonstration of this task, working of this circuitry and now in this video, we will just see the description and explanation of the source code. Before I start, please support my channel by clicking on the subscribe button. Let's dive into the source code. We will see the explanation of each of the register step by step or block by block. Consider this code as of three blocks: initialization, main body, and IVT, interrupt vector table. In first block, first two lines are added because they are idle files. Compiler must know what keywords are we using to communicate with the microcontroller. The other three lines are global variables. I used a channel zero variable for knowing the, or dealing with the channels 0 to A7. And I used the port variable to deal with the port because there are three ports, one for input and two for my output. So I have to differentiate between them using this variable port, and I use the ADC data array of 8 rows because to store the data of different ADCs at the different level in the different rows of my ADC array. Now considering the second main block, SRE register is used for enabling the global interrupt. I will explain the bits of SRE if you commit me in the comment box in another video. Next register we will see ADC SRA. We will see this register bit by bit. This is the bits logic combination 1 0 0 0 1 1 1 0 I used in this S code. Bit 7 is add-in bit, mean ADC enable. We will set this bit to 1 because we will enable the ADC. Bit 6 ADSC, ADC start conversion. We will clear this bit for now because first we will initialize our registers and then we will start the conversion later. Bit 5 88 ADC auto trigger enable. We will clear this bit auto trigger enable because we are just starting a conversion manually using bit 6. Bit 4 ADC interrupt flag. This bit is used as a flag when the conversion is completed and the data registers are updated. This bit is used for polling method, and in this example, in this task, we have I have used the interrupt enable bit. I have set this bit to 1 because I am using the interrupt method. Last three bits are combinational bits used for setting the prescaler. In this example, we have used the prescaler 64. Prescaler matters in the conversion of our ADC. Selecting the low prescaler leads to the fast conversion, but may have an error of precision of our conversion. 64 is mostly used because as we want precision in conversion, not a conversion in the less time. The SFIOR bit is used for the logic or the method for polling. In this task, SFIOR register will be not used in the interrupt method. ADMUX is ADC multiplexer selection register. The bits combination of ADC is like this, and I will explain this register bit by bit. These two combinational bits are used for selection of a reference. This combination is for this reference, mean any external reference you want to give for the conversion. This combination lead to the VCC, external VCC you want to add up, and this is reserved. This combination cannot be used because it is being used by controller itself. And the last combination is for internal reference of 2.6 volt. We have selected AVCC combination of 0 and 1. You can see here in the circuitry external VCC is applied for simulation. Next, at LAR bit is used for managing data registers. If LR is equal to zero or clear, then it is write adjusted, means our maximum data is stored in the ADCL. In ADCL means ADC low byte register, and our remaining data is stored in ADCH, means high byte. In write adjust, we may have a problem dealing with this two digits, because it may have our main data. We overcome this by left adjust, setting LR to 1. Our maximum data is stored to ADCH, and 2 bits are only stored in ADCL low byte. Mean missing, if we only use ADH register, then we may miss these 2 bits, and this means we just only lose data of 2 bits, means 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. This may not alternate our data. We can deal with this. If we want more precision, then we have to deal with both of the registers. For making more simple, we have to ignore a ADCL register. Next, 5 combinational bits are for the channel selection. In this starting, we will set them all to 0 because it is initialization. In our code, we will change them according to our logic. So we may select the channel and update the data. Next, DDR register, means data direction register, is used for setting the register as setting the port as a output or input, because the register used need a direction. It may be used for the input purpose or for the output purpose. So in the code, first we have to initialize the direction. We have to write 0 cross FF for the output and 0 cross Z00 for input. We will set this ADSC bit of ADCSR register to 1, because now the initialization is finished and then we have to start the conversion, and after that our logic loop will run again and again. While loop is used and it is set to 1 because this part will run again and again. The data at the port C will be stored in the pin C register, and then it will be transferred to the variable PP port. Now we will make a logic to show the data of ADC after conversion on port B and port D. So here is the logic. We will use AND operation between the 0 and 3. So when user will enter the value at port C from 0 to 3, then at port B, the channels of 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, they will be displayed on the port B. And when the user will insert channel number greater than 4 or 4, the data of these channels will be displayed on the port D. In the last block, IVT, interrupt vector table. First, there is need to store the updated or the converted value. The register ADCH has the converted value we will store in our array ADC data. Actually, the array at the backend is working like this. These are the indexes. Channel hold the indexes. When channel is 0, then this row will be updated using this register. As there will be increment, row will be changed to be updated. When the number will increment greater than 7, then it will be automatically set to 0. Along with the array data storage, we will also change the channel of the ADC. First, we will set them 0, and then we will select our desired channel. As channel variable represents our desired ADC channel, whenever the interrupt is received, only the row of that channel will be updated. When conversion is completed, so the conversion bit is set to zero, so we have to again set it to one, so the again conversion will be started. Thank you. If you like my video, please hit the like button and please support my channel by clicking the subscribe button. If you have any query, please drop in comment section.